Look at me. Well, hello, ladies and gentlemen. It is 2 o'clock. It is. What are we today? Is it Thursday?
It is Thursday. Thank you.
Jazzlyn Ramirez is here to help me keep tabs on what day it is and my calendar and everything. But much more importantly than that, she is Miss Fiesta
2023
for about, 20 more days?
Yes, only for a short time left, but I'm very excited to be here.
Well, let me say hello to you, welcome in, and remind everybody this is Pickup Lines presented by Gamez Law Firm, and that means the glove is out. Gamez Law fights. They've been fighting for 50 years practicing law, and they are the presenting sponsor. And I'm happy to report that just a few days ago, they renewed their sponsorship into 2024, so I am eternally grateful for that, and I appreciate all their support. And so we're going to spend some time here with the outgoing Miss Fiesta. As I mentioned, Jazzlyn is on the clock for another 20 days. Feeling bittersweet about that, or how are you feeling right now?
Oh, yes. It is a bittersweet moment, definitely. You know, it was a great year, but, you know, it's coming to an end, and it's time to give it up to the next Miss Fiesta, and I'm excited to see what happens next.
I think I saw, and yes, I don't normally wear, you know, Market Square, Guayabetas in January, but I felt today was a special occasion.
I love it. And it's a beautiful day. And it's
perfect. We could have this in April.
Yes, this would be nice.
They would sell a billion tickets to NYOSA and everything. But I think I saw, like, we're under 100 days now to Fiesta 2024, which is April 18th. And I'm on the Rafael court for John McFadden, Rafael 75. And as fate would have it, we just saw each other last night.
Yes, we did.
It's a beautiful event for the Queen of Soul. Yes. They have their pageant coming up on this coming Saturday night.
Saturday, yes.
At 8:01.
8:01 p.m.
Not 8 o'clock. 8:01.
Yes, 8:01 p.m. Be there sharp.
Sharp. I was so impressed. I believe there's 5 finalists. Mm-hmm. I met all of them last night. And just blown away by, and I've been doing the Fiesta thing for a long time, and I've gotten to know a number of the royalty over the years. And if I were to take all of the queens, the Charro queens, and the Fiesta queens, and the Queen of Soul, and La Reina Feria, all of the queens, the one common thing is just all amazing young women who are so impressive.
No, definitely. They're amazing, and the girls from 2023 were outstanding, and I loved all of them, and we grew an amazing friendship, and it was so much fun being a part of this group, and I love it. And so I wish all the new girls coming in for 2024 the best of luck.
Yeah, so again, we have Queen of Soul this weekend, and then on the 31st, which that's a humongous night. It's the end of your reign.
Yes.
It's the Fiesta poster unveiling. So the finalists have been chosen, but that'll be the night that they select the winner for the Fiesta poster, which is a big deal. And then your successor will be chosen.
Yes, I will be crowning the next Miss Fiesta 2024.
And to be clear, and I talked about Queen of Soul, they're going to have a pageant Saturday night.
Yes.
And you think of pageant, and there's modeling or maybe answering questions and things with the judges and everything. But I guess Miss Fiesta, you guys operated a little differently.
Yes, so Miss Fiesta used to be more of a pageant.
Right.
But they have changed over the years, and it is more of an ambassador program now. Okay. And we, as Miss Fiesta, you are an ambassador of Fiesta and going out in our beautiful city and just representing all these charities that come together for Fiesta.
And you are, I don't know, I mean, I'd be hard-pressed to find someone who has as much San Antonio roots in you and your family as you do. And I want to get into that here in just a little bit. But as I see you wearing the crown, and people are going to be drawn to it right away when they see it on camera.
Of course.
What do you want to tell us about the crown, the symbolism, and is how you feel having worn it now for almost an entire year?
I don't know if you can
tell. Here, let me get you.
You can see the Alamo is in the crown.
I see it, right there on the top.
And it means a lot to me because I actually had ancestors that fought at the Battle of the Alamo.
I have this right here. You are a direct lineal descendant.
Yes.
Concepcion de Los Angeles, Charli Losoya.
Yes, the Losoyas.
The Losoya family, who, according to the Fiesta website, fought, survived, and lived on the Alamo grounds in the early 1800s.
Yes, yes. And it is amazing to have this title as Miss Fiesta representing our city. It's like full circle, and I get to be a part of history just like my ancestors.
I'm guessing you've been to the Alamo, or I don't know if you've had a chance to kind of get, like, behind the scenes, or have you seen anything connected to your family that's there at the grounds, or?
I have, actually. My grandma has helped a lot and has found artifacts, and it's amazing what she has found, and also the statue of Losoya is also there, and it's beautiful, and I love that I get to be a part of history.
So, how you Losoya is the family connection, right?
Yes.
So how many, that's like several generations then,
removed. Yes.
The family tree is quite large.
Yes.
But you have a very large family to begin with.
I do have a very large family to begin with, so it's pretty large, and I'm grateful for it.
Good for you. So was it, were you predestined to be Miss Fiesta? I mean, if any, like, again, not to knock anybody else who competed, but it seems like you were a logical choice.
It was a perfect fit, I guess. Yeah. Full circle, like I said.
Yeah, well, that's a great way to put it. Great. We're talking with Jazzlyn Ramirez here, the outgoing, if you will, Miss Fiesta for 2023. I'm still getting used to saying 2024.
Yes, it's something new.
She brought a few things to show off in a little bit, and we'll get to that here in a minute. We can see part of your sash here and everything, but...
my Miss Fiesta sash.
Are you looking forward to not having to wear the crown anymore? Like, I mean, physically, like, not having to wear it.
I'm actually sad.
Are you okay?
I love it. I really do love my crown, and it does get a little heavy at times.
Right.
But I'm going to miss it.
Yeah.
I am going to miss it.
Yeah, but I'm sure you'll find a nice, prominent place to display it, and you'll have all the memories to look back on.
No, definitely. I have tons of memories. It's amazing.
Tell me what you're thinking now as opposed to a year ago at this time when you were getting ready for the poster unveiling night and you didn't know if you were going to win. What kind of emotions are going through you, and how has your reign played out in terms of what you thought it might be?
Oh my goodness. The night of the crowning, I had no idea. I was just going in there open-minded,
right,
and just ready to see what can happen, and when my name was called, I was in shock. I literally had no idea, like, what to do.
Right.
I just remembered rehearsal, and I was like, okay, I need to do whatever we talked about in rehearsal. But it was amazing, and I had my family there, and actually, my whole family bought Fiesta memberships just for that, and they didn't even know. They didn't know if I was going to win or not, but I think over 100 of my family members bought Fiesta memberships for that night.
Oh my goodness, the Fiesta Commission should send you flowers every year now, I guess. But that's a great thing that you mentioned that, because my wife and I recently just became members, and it was brought to my attention right before we came on. So the poster unveiling is on the 31st,
yes,
right?
Yes.
If you buy a membership, I think it's like $60 a person, or like $100, $110 for a couple, then you get invited. You can go to the poster unveiling on the 31st, and you're invited to other exclusive events.
Yes.
And the Fiesta Commission, I'll cover up my address, but they'll send you stuff in the mail like this, and tickets and stuff that you'll get. So it's exclusive stuff. So you have an opportunity, if you want to go online to the Fiesta website, and you can sign up to be a member. It's very inexpensive, considering what you get.
No, really. And you do get a lot. You get to go to all these exclusive events and the meetings, and it's awesome. My family loved it, and they bought another membership again, so...
The Fiesta Commission might have to hire you to be like, helping out with membership sales and stuff like
definitely.
That.
No, definitely. They were so excited. They just saw my whole family coming in. They were like, oh, this is perfect.
That's the Jazzlyn Ramirez family coming in, all 100 of them. Deborah Rodriguez is on. Hello to everybody on Facebook, by the way. Those of you watching, if you have a comment or a question for Jazzlyn, I'm sure she would love to. We should brag on you, because I understand you just graduated from college.
I did.
Weeks ago.
I did. I just graduated from the University of Incarnate Word in December.
Go Cardinals.
Yes.
Congratulations. So having the reign, going to school, I mean, what a crazy time in a good way for you.
Yes. It was a very busy year. I was going to school, and I was also working part-time at the Toyota plant for a supply company.
My gosh.
And I was doing my Miss Fiesta duties, and it was amazing. My boss was very understanding, and she was supportive of Miss Fiesta.
Yes.
So shout out to Forma. They were amazing.
Good.
And it was a great year. It was a great year. Very busy, but an amazing year.
Yes. When you get involved with Fiesta, it's exhilarating, but it is a lot of hard work, as you know.
Yes.
But it's memories and friendships that you have for a lifetime now. And I wonder, as you look back on the last 12 months, is there a moment or two, or maybe something unexpected that happened, where you were at a place and something, you got emotional, or something really struck you that you're going to hold on to that for the rest of your life?
Yes. That's actually the thing that I think of, is the night of the Flambeau Parade.
Mm.
And I have gone to the Flambeau Parade ever since I was a little girl.
You sat on your dad's shoulders.
Yes.
Yes.
At the Battle of Flowers and the Flambeau, both parades I've been attending since forever. And the Flambeau Parade, my whole family was there.
Right.
And it was just a very emotional night, having them cheer for me. And not even my family, but the city. Like, it was beautiful. You know, people screaming, "Show your shoe."
Yes.
It was a beautiful night. And I did cry. I had some tears coming down at the end. But it was amazing. And that night definitely touched my heart. And it was beautiful. And that's an experience I'm going to have forever.
We can't see her boots, and I'm not going to ask her to raise her boot up to the camera, but I'll take a picture later and I can post it on social media, because you wonder how many thousands of times you had to lift your foot up to show people your...
It was a lot. And my legs were actually sore. It was like working out. It was a workout. Yes. It definitely was. It really was a workout, especially with the big dress.
The dresses. Lifting the dress and all that stuff. I will tell people, because I've been blessed to be on two Ray Faeo courts, and I know not everybody gets the opportunity, but if you ever get a chance to ride in a Fiesta parade, and not to say that I have favorites, but the Flambeau is such an unbelievably unique experience. It's just wall-to-wall people.
No, definitely.
As you know.
It's beautiful. It's like the whole city is just there. And it's just
on that Saturday
crowds,
night.
Crowds, and lights and everything. Mm-hmm. It is amazing. That's one thing I suggest to people, whenever they come to visit, that's where they need to go.
Yeah, very good. All right, so we're talking to Jazzlyn Ramirez here, Miss Fiesta 2023. You still have work to do, though, because the night, we mentioned the January 31st, the poster unveiling, new Miss Fiesta named, all that stuff, the end of your reign, as if that wasn't enough. Someone will go home that night, other than Miss Fiesta, will go home a big winner.
Yes, a winner.
For the first time ever, the Fiesta Commission, and I have the notes here, it's a Fiesta sweepstakes, and essentially what's at stake, they're calling it the ultimate Fiesta experience.
Yes, yes.
And it's a page. I don't even have... It's like it's two pages worth of things this person will win.
It is an amazing experience. That's for sure. That's what they'll be winning. There's tickets for the Flambeau Parade, for Nyosa, for Fiesta Oyster Bake, for everything. And it's awesome.
There's hotel stays. There's meals. Yes. There's VIP. It's not just tickets to things, like you said, but it's like VIP experiences, which is like next level stuff.
Yes.
And it literally is two pages. I'm not going to bore you with all of it right now, but... So here's the deal. I have tickets here. You can buy, this is what the ticket looks like, but you can buy the tickets. They're $100 a piece, and the money goes back in to help raise scholarships.
Yes, for the Miss Fiesta contestants.
Exactly. So it's for a good cause. Yes. But you buy the tickets, and then whoever's name is drawn on the 31st, again, will win. It's being billed as the ultimate Fiesta experience. And I read over it again this morning, and I'm like, yeah, I don't know that you're going to be able to get all of that stuff.
It's awesome.
Yeah. Yeah. So again, another reason to go online, buy a membership to the Fiesta Commission, buy your tickets for the ultimate Fiesta experience, and find out more about what Jazzlyn and the Fiesta royalty do. So pretty cool stuff. Okay. So, you brought some pictures here.
I actually have, this is from my graduation.
So let me show, this was in December, right? This was just recently.
Yes.
And as you might expect, a lot of red and black for UIW. So you wore the crown?
I did.
On graduation day?
I wore it for my pictures.
You didn't go up and get your diploma?
No. I did have my little stole, you
had
your, though.
You had, that's right. You had your cap, your mortarboard on. Yeah, so.
And I actually have the picture of the Flambeau night whenever I shared the special moment with...
Okay, I recognize the Fristos there.
Yes.
John and Carrie Fristo. They're all right. They're pretty good people. And yes, if you cut them on their arm, they will bleed Fiesta. Like, those, literally, the Fristos are pretty cool.
Those are my Fiesta parents, I like to call them.
Exactly. Yeah, they're really good. So, that's super cool.
They're amazing. And then, of course,
Yeah, I recognize this.
The flambeau. Again.
The flambeau parade. So you're on, and it's hard to explain. I know the camera probably doesn't do it justice here, but you're on that illuminated float, and you're going down whatever it is, Broadway or whatever street it is, and it's just, it's so many people. And like, I did it one time, and I knew my family was sitting out there, and it's still hard to find them because it's so loud and so many people.
I was trying to scope people out, and I could hear my name.
People
and,
yelling at you, and you're like, where? Like, where?
Yes,
what? Huh?
I don't know where to look. But, and then this is actually the Battle of Flowers parade.
Okay. Oh, in front of the Alamo.
Yes. And sadly, our float actually broke down right before we took off on the Battle of Flowers parade. Yes, we had 4 flat tires. So we had to improvise.
No way.
Yes.
And I was like doing that. What? So, okay.
So that we are actually on the military ambassador Humvees there. We had to improvise, and we hopped on with the military ambassadors, which they came to our rescue. Because we were going to walk it. All the queens were going to walk it.
Oh, my gosh. In your boots and everything?
Yes.
So I'm just looking here in the picture. I recognize it. Is it Queen of Soul, the Charro Queen, and then the young lady next
Miss
to you?
Miss San Antonio.
Is Miss San Antonio.
Yes.
And I would imagine you guys spent just countless hours together.
Yes, yes, we
did. Got to know each other really well.
Amazing. We all became great friends, and it was amazing. We still keep in touch.
And you will keep in touch probably for the rest of your life, I would think, for a long time. Angie Rodriguez is ready for the Battle of Flowers this year. Cannot wait. And yes, if you don't have a story of a float breaking down or a flat tire or something, then you really haven't experienced a parade.
Exactly. Exactly. There's always something that happens, but...
Always.
It's so much fun. It was a blast.
Yeah. So do you have plans for Fiesta? Or let me ask you this. Do you have any official duties for Fiesta 2024, or are you completely done?
I'm pretty much done by the end of January. January 31st will be whenever I hand over my crown, sadly. But after that, I'm going to enjoy Fiesta on the sidelines, but I will be there. I'll be at Fiesta, and I'll even be wearing my Miss Fiesta 2023 little button that I have, so...
It's fantastic stuff. I wonder too, like, how many young girls came up to you, or you know, boys too, but girls in particular. I know with the queens, it's so many. I always notice the looks in their eyes when they see you go by, walk by, or float by, or whatever, and their eyes just get like this big.
It's a beautiful feeling. They really think just they see the crown and they're like, oh, the queen,
right.
And I just bring so much joy to them, and that makes me so happy. It really does.
There are so many stories, too, of for Ray Feo or Miss Fiesta, whatever the case may be, where these scholarships either saved them in some way or went really far to helping them with their education. I wonder if you had a similar experience.
So the scholarship that I won from Miss Fiesta honestly helped me a lot. UIW is an amazing school, but, you know...
Not the least expensive school on earth.
Yes, but whenever I heard my name, I didn't even, that's not what I thought but it just, it was an amazing feeling.
Right.
Knowing that Fiesta was there to support me on my scholarship.
I love it.
Fiesta is amazing. Like, they do so many things, and it's awesome.
It is. Now, we have some comments coming in. I want to make sure we see this. Mara Coates says, congratulations on your graduation. Enjoy the last few months, or I guess in weeks. In this case, you are an absolutely beautiful young woman and will do amazing things in this world.
Thank you.
So along those lines, now that you've graduated, obviously, and you're about to give the crown away, what does Jazzlyn want to do in 2024 and beyond?
Well, I'm currently looking for my full-time position, so that's what I'm doing right now, job searching, which is fun, so much fun. It is a...
Sometimes, you say,
It's a full-time job, looking for a job.
Yes,
it really is.
It absolutely is. So, wait till you're my age and you have to do it too. It's like,
So that's what I've been doing, is been just meeting with people, you know, scoping things out, but it's nice.
What an amazing platform, though, to have had this experience and to be able to go out and try to find a job. I would think that it looks really impressive on a resume.
Yes, it does. And this honestly has helped me so much to, you know, to understand myself and to grow myself. And this experience has helped me in an amazing way. And I really do think, I hope this year goes well. I mean, I think it will go well, but...
I like your chances. I mean, I'm not a fortune teller by any means, but I like your chances. So, but y'all, we'll have to stay in touch.
Yes.
And whenever you land that big job, whatever it is, I'll come back and see you again, and we'll do part two.
We'll do an update.
I'm guessing this video, one way or another, might end up, in front of a parent or a young teenage girl one day who will might be considering, pursuing Fiesta royalty. Mm-hmm. I wonder if there is such a thing as an ideal candidate for Miss Fiesta, or if you were to speak directly to young girls out there, if you could give them advice or kind of best practices on how to do it well and make it happen.
I think the best advice that I could give y'all is to be yourself, mm-hmm. and be genuine, and be personable with everyone.
Right.
You know, you have to be understanding and compassionate with others. And I love whenever people just come up to me and just talk to me, tell me about their day,
yeah.
and just listen. And so just be yourself and
yeah.
be genuine. That really takes you far.
And I know for you, though, but you always have to be on.
Yes.
You know, if you will. But I've heard so many stories over the years, like the impact that you will have on a young person might not be realized for decades from now.
Yes.
Because there are stories where somebody like today might say, oh, I remember when I was a kid and they came in the 90s or in the 80s, Miss Fiesta came to my school and I met Ray Faye or King Antonio, mm-hmm. whatever. It had such an impact. So Bernard Cruz is asking what your major was at UIW.
So I majored in business administration with a concentration in management.
Okay. I read somewhere, a little birdie told me you like to cook.
I do love to cook. I yeah. really do love to cook. So that's what I like to do whenever I get home. And when I'm not on my Miss Fiesta duties, I'm at home cooking or looking up recipes. So
what's your specialty? If I said, Jazzlyn, make me your best dish for dinner tonight, please, what would that be?
Man, I make anything, honestly.
Oh.
I really do. I've made birria. I've made...
What?
Yes.
And that's not easy to make, is it? I mean,
no.
Well, it's a process.
Yes, it is. It
okay.
is a process. I love, during the winter, I love making gobble.
Because I was going to ask you, it's supposed to be like 17 degrees on MLK Day.
Yes.
Next week on Tuesday. I'm just wondering, Jazzlyn's in the kitchen...
Going to be making chicken gobble next week. That is
gosh.
For sure. To stay warm, and it's going to be a cold one next
now,
week.
Is it a because since you're talking about your family, are these recipes that were handed down from generations ago?
I had help, but
okay.
I wouldn't say they've been handed down, but my tia and my grandma, they love to cook also, so I kind of just picked up from them.
Gosh, I bet everything they make is delicious.
Oh, it's amazing. It is. It really is.
I'm sorry. I got distracted. I was thinking about food and,
No. And Fiesta, it was amazing going to like Nyosa and eating all the food and everything. It was, I loved it.
I was going to ask you because, I mean, it's tricky sometimes. You get the crown and your dresses and you got protocol and all this stuff. Can you really enjoy chicken on a stick and all of the goodies?
I did enjoy it a couple of times, but it is hard. It
yes.
is hard. It's, you have to sneak it in there.
Well, my experience being on the court, and you know this, I liken it a lot to speed dating, where
yes.
you go to a place, you make an appearance, shake hands, hello, yes, thank you, would you
yes.
like a drink? Oh, here, have a taco. And then you take a bite. Okay, thank you, I have to leave now, on
yes.
to the next thing. And then you jump in, I guess you had a car, or you had a driver.
Yeah, I actually, this is
yes.
a car. My Sequoia.
A Toyota. I was
yes.
gonna guess it was a Toyota. Okay, so you jump in your Sequoia and you go a couple of blocks or whatever, and you show up, you walk in, do it all over again.
Yes.
And by the end of the night, you've been handed like 20 tacos and 10 drinks and
exactly. It's exactly like speed dating. That is a perfect way to put it. I think I would go to like 10 events in one day. Just walk in, 30, 40 minutes. Walk back out,
right.
go to the next one.
And you're wearing the boots a lot of time. I mean,
yes.
you're not wearing, like, you know, air memory foam,
no.
pillowy cloud shoes. It's
no.
They're beautiful boots, but they're boots. I mean,
They are.
So.
I'm just glad I wasn't wearing heels all the time,
oh.
which I did have to wear them sometimes, but the boots did come in handy. The boots really did come in handy. So.
Yes, okay. So if you had to do it all over again, and if I came to you a year ago and said, all right, you're about to do this, would you have changed anything?
No, I wouldn't. It was amazing. Even the float breaking down was awesome. I enjoyed everything from it. It was an amazing experience, and I wouldn't change anything.
Yeah.
It was awesome.
Yeah. A few more minutes here with Jazzlyn Ramirez, Miss Fiesta 2023, again for about 20, 21 more days.
Yes.
And then you're going to hand over the crown. What do you think on the 31st? What will that night be like for you, do you think?
Probably a lot of tears.
Yeah.
But they're happy tears. They're tears that, you know, I know that I have all these memories to look back on. But it's a bittersweet night. It was great while it lasted, but it's time for the next one to come.
Yeah, yeah. And you know exactly what those finalists are going through right now.
Yes. Oh, definitely. I told them, just be themselves. Like I said, just be themselves and it'll work out.
Yeah.
It'll be great.
Yeah. You know, you lived through the pandemic, obviously, and so you know what it was like when Fiesta was taken away, and you know what it was like to have a Fiesta in June.
Oh, yes. And I remember that. That was a hot one.
May that never happen again.
I know.
Were you involved in any of that in an official capacity?
I was not there, or I wasn't, like, in the Fiesta realm, but I went, and it was a hot Fiesta. That was a very hot
Fiesta.
I'll never forget.
And again, may it never happen again that way.
Yes.
I guess as we wind down here, a lot of people always like to know, like, your outfits. And I know you had a million dresses and all that stuff. And I'm drawn to your earrings, obviously.
Thank you.
So people always want to know, where do you get your stuff?
So we actually had a shopping day right before Fiesta, and we went to, like, multiple boutiques. This is actually from Impeccable Pig. My earrings are from Bucky's, actually.
Wait, do you eat Bucky's?
Yes.
Like Beaver Nuggets?
Yes.
Ah!
Who
knew?
I know. They were beautiful, and I was like, these would be perfect. They're colorful and vibrant. So they're from Bucky's.
Now you can officially get anything at Bucky's. Like, I did not have Fiesta earrings on my Bucky's checklist, but
you could get anything at
Bucky's. And if my wife sees this, the next time we go to Bucky's, I know where she will be.
Yes.
Okay. Well, and so do you get to keep all that stuff?
I do.
It's yours.
To keep everything. I get to keep all my gowns.
Yeah, repurpose that.
My boots, everything. I get to keep everything. It's awesome.
Okay. Well, listen, I am so thrilled to have gotten to visit with you today. Do you have any other pictures or anything you want to show off here?
I do, actually.
Okay.
I have one of my medals.
Look at this thing. What?
Yes.
This is like a dinner. I could eat dinner off of this thing. It's so big. Look at, I had not seen this, Jazzlyn.
So that's actually
second. Let me get in here real tight.
The one that I've made for myself. Well, my family made it.
I love it.
Thank you.
I love it, love it, love it.
Thank you.
And you have a few of these left over.
I do. I have a few.
Well, I'm going to cherish this because people know I'm a metal fanatic, and I love all of this thing. Will you have a metal in 2024?
You know, I did not think about that.
Okay, well,
that's something to think about, actually.
You've already done enough, but I mean, I'm going to have to put this thing on here. Well, I want to remind everybody one more time, that, you know, Jazzlyn, obviously, on the 31st is the poster unveiling ceremony. If people want to be there, you can buy your membership to the Fiesta Commission for, I think it's like $65.
Yes.
And then you get invited to all of those events. And the ultimate Fiesta experience sweepstakes, the winner will be drawn on that same night, the 31st.
Yes.
And so you can get your tickets for $100 and win. It's literally two pages worth of meals, hotel stays, VIP tickets, and everything. So it's going to be a lot of fun. I am so thrilled for you. I really mean it. I want to find you in a year or whatever and see whatever amazing things you're doing. And hopefully you can come back in the car and we can catch up.
That'd be amazing.
But what a great inspiration you've been to so many young people in our community. And here's some many more years of success.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate
There she is. Miss Fiesta for three more weeks. Miss Fiesta 2023. Jazzlyn Ramirez. All the best to you and your family.
Thank you so much.
Congratulations on your success. Very good. Okay. Now I want a chicken on a stick.
Definitely.
All right. We'll wait a few more days. This has been another episode of Pickup Lines presented by Gamez Law Firm. Don't forget Gamez Law Fights. And another episode of Pickup Lines tomorrow. More on that coming up very soon. But again, thanks. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Okay. We'll see you soon.
Bye.
Viva Fiesta.
Viva.